second of the medal-winning events got underway today, and it was time for the men's team final. All of the teams had already guaranteed themselves places at the Tokyo Olympics. Now this was all about the medals. The Russian Federation had qualified in top spot, followed by the People's Republic of China and Japan. But with three up, three to count, the format was going to be difficult for all teams concerned. Ukraine had progressed through to the final in fourth place with some wonderful performances in qualification. They began on the pommel horse before moving to rings, where 26-year-old Yevgen Udenkov, who had been part of their world championship team in Montreal, produced this exercise. With style, strength, and swing, he finished the routine to score 13.733. Ukraine played a strategic game today, deciding not to put up Oleg Verniaev and Petro Pakhniuk on many apparatus, choosing to save them for the all-around final. However, Igor Radivilov impressed with this exquisite vault to help them score 246.593, with Ukraine finishing in eighth place. Switzerland had focused in qualification and were keen to impress once more. Benjamin Guichard, part of the bronze medal winning team at the 2016 European Championships, performed this wonderful vault to score 14.266. 25-year-old Oliver Heggie, European champion on the horizontal bar, once again proved he is a consummate performer on this apparatus. With difficulty and swing, he included the death somersault, this very impressive full twisting ginga. He produced the fourth highest score of the day, this excellent routine, and earned himself 14.6. Switzerland finished in seventh. Chinese Taipei started on vault with a very experienced Xu Pingqian, produced this very nice double twisting Sukahara. His teammate Tang Chiai-hung qualified with the highest score on horizontal bar, but competed well on the parallel bars today, scoring 13.533 for this routine. Chinese Taipei have already provided the surprise of the championships by qualifying in eighth place, some 12 points ahead of their total in Doha last year. Li Qikai, a superb worker of the pommel horse, had already scored 14.966 in qualification, earning himself a place in the final. He went one better today, this beautiful routine, scoring a huge 15.0 to take Chinese Taipei into a historic sixth place. Great Britain placed fifth in qualification and maintained their position in the finals today. 20-year-old Joe Fraser got them off to a very strong start on the rings. Team member with the silver medal winning Great Britain team at the Europeans in 2018 was solid on this apparatus, giving them confidence for the rest of the event. His routine earned him 14.333. Finishing here with a double twisting, double back somersault. James Hall, always a dependable member of the British team, produced this outstanding vault to score 14.666. A faultless landing, another great performance from the British gymnast. Dominic Cunningham, was the final performer on Vault for Great Britain, producing this exquisite shoe felt, a 2.5-twisting Yurchenko. 2018 European floor champion has also made the apparatus finals on that apparatus and on vault. Gianni Regini Moran was a superb junior, but has been plagued by injury. He's now coming back to perform for Great Britain in his first senior world championships. He certainly upped his game from qualification to produce this parallel bars exercise. High in the bavsoir and fluent in the swing. He was awarded a score of 13.933, and Great Britain finished their competition in fifth place. The United States of America had had issues in qualification, coming into the team final in seventh place. Time to put things right. Akash Modi began with this beautiful vault, Mr. Consistent producing a score of 14.2. ...27-year-old Sam Mikulak, twice Olympian, had fallen on three apparatus in qualification, only just making it through to the all-around finals in 24th place. However, today he had clearly had a transformation, and the talented competitor showed his style to the world stage on the parallel bars. With beautiful execution and difficulty, he was awarded 15.2 for this exercise. What a difference a couple of days make. After this fabulous routine, the United States of America were definitely back in contention. There were great expectations on the shoulders of Yul Moldauer as he stepped onto the floor. World bronze medalist on this apparatus, he worked confidently and swiftly as he progressed to his routine. The 23-year-old was aggressive, including skills like this, half in, half out, to be awarded with a score 14.4. The United States of America kept their place in fourth at this stage of the competition. And pressure once more fell upon the shoulders of Sam Mikulak, bronze medalist on the horizontal bar at the World Championships in 2018. He was desperate to represent his nation with pride after the problems in qualification. Here, the Cassina and the Coleman adding to the difficulty of the exercise. superb release and re-grasp elements, giving him a score of 14.666. This was the second highest score of the day and cemented fourth place for the United States of America. Japan began their campaign on the pommel horse, where they had incurred many issues in qualification. Senior debutant Daiki Hashimoto started extremely well, a promising gymnast who puts lots of attention on practice, completed his exercise with 14.466. Clearly, the practice has paid off. Yuya Komoto, at 25, making his World Championship debut relatively late in his career, but an important member of the team, the particular strength on this apparatus, the rings. Shoulders low. In the cross. Holding all of his strength elements with form and precision. Impressive O'Neill combination into the Maltese. Excellent work from Komoto, earning him the highest score of the day on this apparatus, 14.766, and a great contribution to Japan. Kazuma Kaya had performed so well in qualification, earning himself a fourth place in the all-around competition, but today was all about the team. Mental rehearsal before his exercise on the horizontal bar. Focus was on the task at hand. He'd already taken a bronze medal with the team in Doha, and with this performance, he wanted to keep his team in a medal-winning position. Clean in the release and re-grasp elements. Superb execution, finishing with a double-double to score 14.225. The emotion was palpable. Japan finished their competition on the floor with the promising Daiki Hashimoto here performing an excellent double twisting, double tuck. It was always going to be tight for the medals, and every performance mattered. Unfortunately, this fall was costly. Disappointment for Hashimoto and bronze for Japan. Reigning world champions, the People's Republic of China, began on the floor with world champion all around from 2017, Zhao Ruoteng. The 23-year-old is such a strong competitor here, including the 3.5 twist, half twist combination. Beautiful double twisting, double tuck, and a difficulty score of 6.2 for this exercise. Highest score of the whole day, 15.033 on floor. The People's Republic of China were off to a flying start. With every point critical, Zhao Ruoteng took to the vault. Performing with a 5.6 difficulty, he went for it. The step forward may be crucial. Xu Jingquan, on his favourite apparatus, the parallel bars, had had a problem in qualification, not making it through to the finals. The world champion on this apparatus did not disappoint in the men's team final. In an almost faultless routine, he accrued a difficulty of 7.0. Amplitude, virtuosity, and a masterclass on the parallel bars. With a score of 16.383, this huge contribution to the team took them back to the top of the leaderboard. With everything to play for, Sun Wei mounted the horizontal bar, the final apparatus. This was the moment the world champions had to defend their title. Going for the release and regrasp, the straight catch-up, Sun Wei was off, and the hopes of the People's Republic of China dashed. Desperate times for China, and one gymnast could not be consoled. The Russian Federation had come into the team final with the highest score from qualification, led by the reigning all-around world champion Artur Dalaloyan. They were first to start on floor. Russian Federation had never won the team title and were keen to make an impression. He managed to maintain his balance and add to the difficulty to produce this routine. keeping his concentration right to the end. He scored 14.633, the 6-5 difficulty score. David Beliavsky has had a great year, becoming the European Games all-around champion and the champion on this apparatus, the pommel horse. Russian Federation were depending upon him to do a good job. He maintained his composure with accurate hand placements and style in the swing. The 27-year-old drew upon all of his experience to complete the routine successfully and score 14 marks exactly. Nikita Nagonyi has had such a good year. The European all-around champion led from qualification, and the Russian Federation were depending upon his skill. An exceptionally strong competitor in body and mind. He produced this rings exercise to score 14.533. The next apparatus was vault, and once more, the Russian Federation were impressive. With this huge handspring double front somersault in the pike position, he kept Russian Federation in line for the gold. Moving to their final apparatus, it was Ivan Stretovich who was first up. This tall, elegant competitor had to hold his nerve and form, which he did very well indeed. An impressive array of release and catch elements added to his difficulty score. And he ended with the second highest mark of the day, 14.666. It was tight at the top between the Russian Federation and China. They knew they could make history with one routine to go. The hopes of the Russian Federation on the shoulders of Nikita Nagonyi. It was imperative that they stayed on if they were going to take the gold medal. It was not just the Russian Federation holding their breath, but the whole of the arena in Stuttgart who was watching every movement of this routine. Cleanly through the one-armed giant and the stolder. He finished with a double twisting, a double straight, nailing the dismount. And a glorious gold for the Russian Federation. A total score of 261.726. History in the making. The celebrations already starting, and a devastated Sun Wei. Here are the final standings in the men's team event. Bronze for Japan, People's Republic of China takes silver, and the title for the Russian Federation.
Russian Federation!
The victorious Russian Federation celebrate this evening. Four times in the past they've been silver medalists, but this time it's a glorious gold.